Welcome to Enoch's Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video we take a look at parting tools. I also review one of Banggood's blade type parting tools. We look at the differences between the tools and see how they perform. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Today we're looking at parting off tools. This is the parting off tool that came with my Boxford lathe. It's a holder, it has a blade. The size of this blade is 3/32 thick and 5/8 width. And you just move it in and out to suit the depth that you're cutting. And you can sharpen this. It's high speed steel, so you can sharpen it with the grinding wheel. Now that's one that most of you are probably familiar with. And the second one I want to look at is these insert holder parting off tools. This body is 12 by 12 and the parting off tool on this one is 3 millimeters, and I have another one here very similar. This body is 16 by 16, it's on there, and this one's a 2 millimeter parting off tool. Now the one I've used the most so far is this one at the back here, the 3mm. These two are virtually identical except for the thickness of the body. The problem I found with this one is that the tip, being 2mm wide, there's very little support underneath the tip. As you're parting off, if the tip breaks, it usually comes down and takes away some of the front of the 2mm support. That's happened a few times with this tool. I've reformed the shape. I can get away with a small cut or a small depth, but if I'm parting a 1-inch bar off with it, I know I won't get away with it. This one, although it's a smaller body compared to the other one, the support under the tip is more. And I think it's broke once. That caused the tip to dig in. As the tip came down inside the slot it was cut in, it then took away some of the support. I've had more success with the 3mm wide one than a 2mm wide one. This is a new parting off tool. Let's open this up. It's from Banggood. This is the tool holder, 1626, so this is 26mm high to fit a 26mm blade, and the back here, this is 16mm high to fit a 16mm tool holder. If that's bought separately, with this you need to buy the blade that fits the tool holder. In this case it's this SPB 326. Now that means the 3 is 3mm wide tip and the 26 is the height of the blade, so it fits into the holder. Sometimes the manufacturer will number them up the other way around, 26-3, so you've just got to watch out for that. They should still fit, so you need to make sure that you have the right width so you can get these 2mm, 3mm. This blade came with 10 tips. I've fitted one, there's the others, and you can put another insert in this end ready for if you break this one. You just take it out, turn it round, replace it in the holder. So what you do, the same, it's virtually the same as this old type, where you've got the blade and the holder. You tighten the 3 cap heads down to tighten the blade up, and then the tip is just tapped in and held. There's not a cap it or anything to adjust to hold the tip. It's just wedged in to the holder. And I'm hoping if you hit a hard spot in your material or it starts to struggle to cut, rather than pushing down on the tool like that, it will push the tool further back into the holder so it will tighten up. Problem you get with this type of tool is as you get a load exceeding there on the top, it tends to snap the tool and take away half the face below, so you lose the support under the tool tip. Let's put this in the lathe, see how we go. I've fitted the tool holder and the tool into the tool post. Set the tool post square to the chuck along this edge and here, so I know that the tool is square to the chuck. I've tightened up the tool post and I've set the tool tip on the center line with the adjuster and locked that in position. The other thing I've done is bolt my compound slide back so it's not like this, because obviously you've got overhang here and this is overhanging as well, so where the tool would normally be in your tool post and the cutting tool would be about here, this one is about an inch further out. So make sure that my compound slide is level on the end, so any force on the tool will be pushed down onto the compound slide, and I haven't got this compound slide sticking out giving more leverage. And another thing you might need to do is just check that you haven't got your jib strip too loose so that this will flex. There's one thing that I'm not too happy about is the amount that this sticks over. I could take 5mm off the back of this tool to pull this in level, so that would bring the tool cutting tool 5mm further in. And we'll see how we go. So get a piece of steel, put that in the lathe. I've set the tool up, I've set the speed to, it's around 540, 550 RPM for this. And I'll just feed that tip in, and all I'll use is some oil if it needs lubricating. And then what we'll do is we'll change this tool for the other 3mm tool and compare the difference. I've moved the bar out so it's the same distance as it was before with the other tool, so any flexing in the bar or movement in the chuck will still be the same. This tool now is held in the tool holder, so it's obviously closer to the tool post, so we'll just see how this one cuts. It's a new tip and I'm using the same speed. That's the problem I get with these tool holders. For some reason I was using the same feed, same speed, it was cutting okay, and then all of a sudden just loses it. And I think what it is that the tool, if you look now, there's a tool on the side profile. You can see that the tool has snapped off just above the support, and in doing that it usually takes some of the support with it, but this time it's snapped off here. The belief is that there's not enough support in this part of the tool holder to support the tool, so when you get pressure on the tool it flexes down on this, and then it just takes a little crack because this is not solid enough to support the tool. And this is a 3mm tool, the same as the other one. You have a look at the bar, see if the tip's embedded in it. You can see here the tip has dug into the bar and then flexed on the holder and just cracked the tip off. And that's the problem I get with the 2mm and the 3mm in the other type of holder. So I'll try this new holder, see how if I get that problem. I shouldn't do, because the new holder has more support under the tool compared to the other tool. You can see the difference in the support, it's probably twice as much. And also any force on the tool is forcing the tool, because it's at a 45 degree angle, it's trying to force the tool back into the holder. So I'm hoping this is a better, or will last longer than this type. Now if you look closely where the tip was here, it's rounded off the edge. When this tip broke, obviously the majority of it came downwards, rounds off the edge of your tool holder. So next time you put a tip in, there is less surface to hold the tool, and they just keep breaking. So I was running that at the same speed, it's the same width of tool, set up square within a couple of thou. Well, it has parted off on the second attempt. It's taken twice as long to do it because I couldn't use the same feed rate that I did on the first one. What I did to this, I ground the face back so that the tool has a square edge to rest on. I turned the tip round, so that's another new cutting tip to the original one. Obviously the original one broke off, and still it was struggling to get through the bar. I noticed when I put oil on, it seemed to stop it cutting, so it doesn't like oil. So whether that is the tip profile is not the same as the other one. I think part of the problem with the tooling is the amount that this sticks out from the holder. You look there, you can't go in much further than that because this comes up and then you have this part coming out so you can tighten the tool up. But on the blade type, you can see how far in it is compared to the other one. Get the two tool holders together
and you can see the left hand one is nearly twice as far out as the right hand one is. So that means any force on the left hand one has got more leverage, and that's probably why these snap off. With this one, the blade type is a lot closer to the compound slide, so that there's less leverage. So all I'll do on this now is see if I can mill about 5mm off this end, so it comes in further and reduces the leverage on that twist.
Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was interesting. Hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, why not subscribe? We'll see you next week on Enos Engineering.